Oppenheimer cast. It's usually a bit of a surprise with these films, right? It doesn't always give it away. Seth, Ernest. All right. Hans Bader. He is a gun. So if you don't know who this guy is, he's going to play a prominent role. Is this the guy who plays Floki in Vikings? He looks like him, but yeah, he is. I couldn't recognize him without the war paint or whatever it's called. That's awesome. That's a great choice. So Hans Bader is a big gun, okay? Big, big, big gun. I mean in real life, like in physics. Teller, another prominent man. Another prominent physicist. So Einstein, Tom Conti. So they're going to get Einstein in it. That's good to see. I wasn't sure if they would do that because he's somewhat of a... wasn't directly involved, you know what I mean? He played some... definitely a role in this time and all, in many ways, but in terms of the Los Alamos making the bomb, not really. Good choice. Looks like a good fit. Who else have we got? Enrico Fermi, another super prominent physicist. Wow, looks a bit young, maybe a bit too young for Enrico Fermi, but sure. This Saturday right now, people have no idea how, what, Casey Affleck is in this? For real? That's cool. Yeah, I think he would be a great choice for a lead character, to be honest. One of the prominent physicists. Yeah, as I was saying, I think this is going to do a great, great deal for Florence, isn't it? I'm not a big fan of her, to be honest. I liked her in that Midsommar movie. Was that one of her early movies? Probably. Rami? That's a good choice. And who is Matt Damon playing? Oh, Jesus Christ. So they haven't... we don't know who he is playing just yet. All right, so that's interesting. Leslie Groves, interesting choice. I was surprised that freaking Robert Downey Jr. and Ben Affleck will play in it. Ben Affleck? Is you sure Ben Affleck is in it? I haven't... where is Ben Affleck? Robert Downey Jr. will be a good fit. Physicists are notoriously cheeky, and I think he's got the cheek. Oh, wait, he is in it. What the hell? Holy shit. Ben Affleck as well as Casey Affleck. Damn. It's going to be the movie of the century. I love that they've got Floki in it. I'm not going to lie. He's probably my favorite choice out of all of these people. Apart from this guy, I think he is perfect as Oppenheimer. It's perfect casting. This guy will be perfect as Hans Bader. This is perfect. Nally on this level. I love... I saw another... oh, damn. There's one other guy. There was one more guy I just saw at the last second before I closed it. Where is he? Dylan Arnold. Frank Oppenheimer. So he's... yep. Where is he? Ooh, I love this actor as well. That's going to be cool. He is great in Cloud Atlas. You guys seen Cloud Atlas? He plays one of my favorite movies, Cloud Atlas. It's magical. It is so magic. The Philosophers. That's interesting. This guy. Have you guys ever seen the Metallica movie that they made, Through the Never? He was the lead in it. I thought it was sick. I loved it. I think I love this guy. He's a perfect fit for a physicist. Really good actor, and just... he's got like that dark sense to him, doesn't he? Darkness. I love Josh Hartnett. Black Hawk Down. Awesome movie. He's in it as well. Nice. Who else have we got? Emily Blunt's really good. She's an awesome fit. I just realized how many actors in this, so I should probably actually have a more serious look. Love this guy. Love this guy in Good Times. You guys seen Good Times? Good shit. Yeah, I was surprised by Josh Peck being in it, but that's... hey, he's a good fit, I think, for a physicist. He's got a cheeky, childish charisma to him. He's cool. I like him in that Christmas movie. I remember watching when I was like 10. Who else is there? I don't know these guys. That's cool. I love new actors. This guy's cool. He was good in Tenet. I think that's it. And I love this guy in what's his name? Zack Snyder's movies. And that heist one that he made, the sequel, or the prequel thing. That was great, wasn't it? The zombie heist movie that had no zombies in it. That was hilarious. You're excited about him, right? I'll be honest, I absolutely can't see being in there. I see. No, I think this guy has a lot of... So I've watched a couple of movies of this guy, and I think, for one, he looks like some physicists I've actually met. So I think he'll... And he's got charisma. I think a lot of people, to be honest, like, Checker, you're quite young, right? So you probably haven't met a lot of research physicists who don't... who aren't maybe lecturers and things like that. There's a lot of people who look like this who I've met a lot, and a lot of like people who look like him, to be honest with you, and very charismatic people. I think he'll be perfect, a perfect fit for an honest representation. And I think he's a really good actor, so I think it's perfect. I honestly think he's one of the more perfect people for it as well. So I think you're going to be pleasantly surprised. Although, you know, it'll depend on how you look at physicists. But a lot of people who have never met physicists are going to be very... Well, they're not going to know what to think, right? Reacts to Matt Damon losing out on 250, rejecting Avatar offer. Interesting. German actor, very nice. But he would really need to change his persona for the role. No. No. I think you've got it all wrong, Checker. I think a lot of people think that physicists are meant to be super nerdy and very quiet and introverted all the time. But that's exactly not the case. Sure, there's plenty of those. There's plenty of Richard Feynman types, though. Very extravagant, charismatic. And I think his flair reminds me of a few people I know who are really great physicists, like in real life, personally. I think he's perfect. Ian, generally, quite funny. And anyway, that's enough of that. What